Sewage pipe gaming.
Judge Dredd is undoubtedly one of the most iconic characters in comic book history. And over the years, there have been several attempts to bring his brand of hyper-violent, satirical mayhem to life in the world of video games, with varying degrees of success. However, in the early 90s, one of the hottest video game companies on the planet, Midway, who were responsible for the global smash success of Mortal Kombat, spent almost 2 years developing a Judge Dredd coin-operated machine which was set to take the arcades of the world by storm and rightfully cement Dredd's place in the consciousness of mainstream pop culture. But before the game was even finished, it was unceremoniously scrapped and sent to recycle. Over the course of this video, we will find out what the drokk happened to Judge Dredd, the arcade game. In 1992, games company Midway were riding high on the success of their mega hit Mortal Kombat, along with other titles like NBA Jam and Killer Instinct. Mortal Kombat was soon dubbed by the gaming press of the time as King of the Arcade. The only thing matching the game's success was the controversy it caused, resulting in hearings being held by Senators Joseph Lieberman and Herb Kohl. Although it may seem laughable to the sensibilities of a modern gamer, the graphics of the first Mortal Kombat game were at the time state-of-the-art, thanks to the technique of filming real actors performing moves on a stage and then digitizing them into sprites, giving game characters a much more realistic look. Couple this with the copious amounts of blood, gore, and the brutally entertaining fatalities, and the senator's blood pressure was higher than a mega city block. The audience, however, lapped it up, with home conversions going on to sell millions of copies, whilst the Mortal Kombat name became a franchise, spawning sequels, music albums, comic books, and eventually a couple of movies. The whole world, it seems, was screaming. Judge Dredd, however, was still considered very underground in the USA circa 1992. Midway artist Eric Kirky is quoted as saying, "In America at the time, for you to be exposed to Judge Dredd, you had to be either A, English with a love for sci-fi, B, a comic book nerd bore, or C, into heavy metal and art and the crossover of Games Workshop and the English grindcore and thrash movements." So why were these American behemoths of arcade game manufacture even interested in our quirky British comic book hero? Well, for that, we have to thank the Terminator. Since 1991, Midway had seen their Terminator 2 twin gun arcade cabinet gain significant popularity with arcade goers, leading to a best-selling home console conversion. The company were on the lookout for another big movie license on which to base an arcade game. Hollywood had recently announced its intentions to make a big-budget Dredd movie, and with Midway programmer Jake Simpson being British and well-stooped in the lore of Judge Dredd, it seemed a perfect time to send old Stonyface into the arcades. And so the violent world of Mega City 1 merged with the digitized bloody combat of Midway in what seemed like a dream pairing. The small team of four guys assembled, and development began in earnest. According to the game's programmers, the initial premise of the Dredd Arcade was supposed to be a cross between Mortal Kombat and Konami's mega-hit Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles game, which was a cooperative multiplayer scrolling beat-em-up. The Dredd movie was still a long way off, and with no hint of any visual direction the film may take, the team decided to stay as faithful as possible to the look of the comic strip. This dedication to the source material means the game features a pretty decent rendering of the Big Meg itself. The game was also the first of any Midway game to use 3D graphics, whilst also being a pioneer in using multicolour cabinet printing too. A prosthetic Judge Dredd head, built for the actor playing Dredd in the game, was photographed up close and used on the side of the game cabinet. Its 3D art gave the cabinet a brilliantly unique aesthetic. For any technophiles out there, the game ran on a Motorola 34010 chip with 16 megs of image space. Programmer Jake Simpson says that they, quote, ran out of memory very early on. Our animations were much nicer originally, but we ran out of space really fast. Well, with a project this ambitious, teething problems were inevitable. The programmers were pushing their tools to the limits. Judge Dredd the Arcade was intended to be a story-led action scroller, where Dredd fought through wave after wave of criminals and robots using his fists, his feet, and sometimes his gun. At one stage, it even had a top-down bike chase level. Everything was in place for Judge Dredd to kick down the doors of the arcade and fire an incendiary round into the competition. So what went wrong? Well, four cabinets were built and sent out to be tested by members of the public in Midway's hometown of Chicago. Unfortunately for Dredd fans, the feedback was not good. In fact, it was downright terrible. Thanks to Jake Simpson, we have access to the notes from the game's actual field test, and it makes for fascinating reading. Under the heading, "Why did it fail?", some of the more scathing comments include: too much memory was spent on background rather than principal characters. Background is too busy, distracting the player. Dredd's control doesn't feel quite right. He's either too fast or he's too slow. No sense of achievement in the game. The first boss, Fink Angel, is neither fun to play nor is he a challenge. Developer Jake Simpson admits that the game is overly hard at times, as it was admittedly designed to be a quarter muncher, sucking in players desperate to beat the game. One comment from the report stands out, reflecting the gaming landscape of the time. Kids today want to fight each other, like in Street Fighter 2 and Mortal Kombat, not cooperate in a side-scroller. But perhaps the most damning and telling comment is saved for the end. It says, "The license has not brought the property anything. Not enough people know who Judge Dredd is and what the world he would inhabit is like. The game is full of little points that Dredd aficionados will pick up but are meaningless to the average player." Ouch. And so the Dredd arcade game was sent for a stretch in the cubes, deemed too underground and obscure to be a true success. If only they were making a huge $70 million Hollywood action movie based on Dredd, starring one of the most famous actors alive. A year or so down the line, and the shadow of Judge Stallone loomed over the offices of Midway, and in an internal document released online, a Midway employee pleads the case for Dredd Arcade. Quote, "The movie is in pre-production. We have been informed of a mass media presentation along with many third-party vendors releasing toys, books and music. This is going to be a big movie and we already have a head start." Midway still held the license to make an arcade machine based on the comic book, and they had a verbal agreement to have access to the movie's art department. Two versions of the script were made available to Midway. Seeing the pivotal role in the movie played by the judge's lawgivers, the intention was to build a light gun game. It seems like this would be a no-brainer, right? Salvage 18 months of development time and get that big movie tie-in that the Midway top brass desired so much. But for some reason, despite it all making perfect sense, the pleas fell on deaf ears. Perhaps the stigma of that first terrible field report was impossible to shake. Maybe the Midway chiefs just didn't like the cut of Dredd's jib. Whatever the reasons, they were resolute, as a further second proposal to save the Dredd project was ignored. they never did get to cash in on Stallone's Dredd movie. That particular honour fell to the developers Probe Software, who released the 1995 movie tie-in. The game was fun and quite playable, but it didn't have Midway's unique visual style. And so as far as Judge Dredd the Arcade was concerned, that was that. It's over. The sentence is death.
Court's adjourned.
The end. Only, it isn't the end. Because thanks to some brilliant anonymous criminal, the game ROMs were released online and are able to be played using emulation software. Finally, the lost Dredd game was found in all its unfinished glory. 18 months of hard work spent on what the developers called a labour of love had been saved, rescued from oblivion by a petty criminal. Oh, the irony. It may never have set the arcade world alight as intended, but as a Dredd fan, I think it's pretty cool to know that in 1993, the world's hottest game makers were enamoured enough with Dredd to put 2 years of time and money into giving him a worthy game. They tried, and some might say they failed. But thanks to modern technology, we could test it for ourselves. But don't blame me if the copyright judges kick down your door and shoot you in the face. And so now, it brings me great pleasure to present to you a complete playthrough of Judge Dredd, the arcade game.
Why should I be frightened?